console player, this game is gonna be for you.
We had the fantasy of the setting first, and then we threw like a ton of mechanics against that idea until we came up with kind of like our own genre, something that feels unique.
We made the game because we had a fantasy stuck in our heads, which was about going on an expedition in the 19th century into uncharted territories of the world and eventually get eaten by a giant crab.
Q's Expedition is a game about failure.
If a game is always like hand-holding you and saying yes to every question you throw at it, it becomes meaningless, right? It just like gently strokes your head and then it has to throw more pre-rendered cutscenes and explosion effects and bombastic scenes into your face to still convince you that you're spending your time well.
Let's not make a game just about like, oh, you are the hero, but let's make a game about where traveling is kind of hard, where you fail a lot, where you fail due to ridiculous reasons.
We decided to rather be truthful and respectable towards the players and like respect their time, but also respect the fact that they are looking for a challenge. The game is structured around short-paced sessions, right? It's like you can play one fulfilling session of the Curious Expedition within 15 to 30 minutes. And I think that's really cool for like being on the go, having your Switch on the lap, or just going on your console for a moment. I want to see this kind of story being told, and then that's where it started.
I think that's why it's also successful, because players can tell that it's kind of different. I'm excited for all the people that will be playing it for the first time, because they will get the benefit of playing like the ultimate edition of C1, kind of like the director's cut of the game.
And then the giant crab comes and eats us.
Yes.